You're a guy who suffered from dyslexia.
No, you never stop. I suffer.
You suffer from it.
Yes.
And, you know, people make jokes about dyslexia. They go, oh, the guy's just stupid. And, you know, they always say, but it's a real thing.
It's a real thing.
When you see a letter on a page,
right.
What does it do? It inverts?
Every human being, it does something else.
You had a miserable childhood because of dyslexia.
Yes. I thought that I was stupid.
Your parents were super cruel about it.
Very short German Jews.
They didn't understand that you had dyslexia? I guess they didn't diagnose it back
then? They did not diagnose it. And I think even if they knew, they wouldn't care.
And your parents used the German word for dumb idiot.
Dummerhund.
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 They renamed you Dummerhund, which means what?
Dumb dog.
Dumb dog.
Yes. Aww.
Your parents, when you were a kid, they'd call you dumb dog.
Yeah, oh, du bist ein Dummerhund.
Right.
You are a dumb dog.
Now, look, you can speak a couple of languages, could they?
Well, I could speak a few words in German and a few words in English.
But when I saw you just do that now, you got tears in your eyes, a little bit, right?
Even
though you're kidding around.
Right.
I mean, you're not kidding around, but you try and tell a light story.
Right.
It's not a light thing with
you. It was not a light way to grow up, no.
When your parents call you dumb dog.
Right.
It's like, what the fuck? I mean, why
did
you have me?
Well, it makes you be a different kind of parent, let me tell you.
Well, are you a better parent?
I don't know yet. You have to ask my kids.
Yeah, but I mean,
you didn't call him dumb dog.
You say you didn't call him dumb dog, but do you think you took your hostilities out in ways you didn't realize?
Maybe, but not on them.
How do you become a better parent if
you've
been raised by parents who are calling you dumb dog?
You work on it. You remember that you do not want to be like them. You hear your parents coming off the tip of your tongue, and you say to your kid, you know what? I did not mean to say it that way. I'm going to start again.
So when you had kids, were you really afraid you would be the kind of parents your parents were?
I didn't know if I could be a parent. I just knew that I was duty bound and I was going to get this right. You never get it right.
I know, but at least you try.
You try.
When your parents are calling you dumb dog and your parents think you're an idiot and an imbecile and they let you know it.
Yes.
I imagine, I don't know if your parents are still alive.
They are not.
When did they die?
98, 97.
But they saw your great success.
They did. Now, they didn't want me to be an actor. You remember, my father wanted me to take over his family business.
Which was
buying and selling wood. They bought and sold wood.
was it lucrative?
Yeah, you know what? We lived above our means, I think.
Right. But meanwhile, they're calling you dumb dog and the old man's just selling wood. So
I'm thinking I need to be an actor. I dream it. I taste it. I live it. I talk it. I walk it.
At what point do you say to your parents, or maybe you didn't say it, but at what point do you go, hey, man, that's it. I'm done with them. They fucking ruined me. I'm hurt by them.
All right. I didn't think that. All I thought was, I'm going to do what I need to do.
Right.
I went to Emerson College.
Did you go to Yale?
I did.
How does a guy with dyslexia, the dumb dog, so to speak?
Because I myself was amazed. But I got it. It's a drama school. I went to the drama school, the graduate school.
How do you get into that? Is it academic?
No, you audition.
What did you do when you auditioned?
I did Launce and the Dog from Shakespeare, and I did a modern speech, and the modern speech was, I don't remember.
But Henry, something doesn't fit in this. If you can't read, and the school didn't diagnose you, and I know that you read your first novel at 30, because you couldn't...
The Clan of the Cave Bear?
Right.
Yeah, that was
you couldn't put it together. How do you memorize?
I'll tell you how.
On Happy Days, how do you memorize
where
the script?
Where there's a will, there's a way. And so I read the scripts very slowly over and over again. And
when you say slowly, if I gave you a piece of paper to read,
I read one word at a time now.
But tell me how this all works out in your life. When you get Happy Days, is that the ultimate fuck you to your parents? You become one of the most famous guys on the planet.
And then my mother says... Yeah, there's a co-producers of Henry Winkler.
Oh, right.
Oh my God, they're taking credit for you now.
I met people all over the world who said, hey, I've got your parents' autograph.
Right. And how many guys did you beat out for that role?
I don't know the exact number, but I have to say that there were a few hundred guys in the room, and that was just the day I went in.
And you didn't know it would be a success. I mean, you're like, hey, I'm just looking for work.
I had six lines.
You want to be a working actor. Up until then, had you done a lot of work?
I did theater.
Right.
I did repertory theater at Yale.
Would you shit your pants when they gave you at Yale a big scene to memorize and suddenly with dyslexia and you've got this image of yourself as a dumb dog? I mean,
all of that combined made it like I was a bowl of jelly.
Do you think it was harder for you to memorize lines because of your dyslexia?
If something is written really well, easy to memorize. It goes in. If the writer has an understanding of the human condition, it goes in like a flowing river.
Right.
If it's just written without any thought. If it's crap writing, it is so difficult to memorize, you can't believe it.
When is the last time you did the Fonzie voice, if you will? Like, when is the last time you actually did it? Like,
maybe a few days ago.
Oh, seriously?
Oh, yeah.
Well, what was the circumstance?
I'll talk to you like the Fonz.
Is that how
you're Howard Stern.
Is that how he talked?
This is it. I changed my voice. I changed my body. You know, hey, Howard, I like you. You could use it like a trim on your hair.